Warning, the following movie review contains spoilers. If anyone has not seen No Time to Die yet, my best tip is to watch the movie first before you watch my movie review. Hey guys, this is Chuck Fan Media here. Today, I'm going to review on No Time to Die, which came out on October 8th, 2021. It is the fifth and final in the Daniel Craig 007 era, and the 25th James Bond movie overall. The film takes place after the events of Spectre, where Bond and Madeline escape from the assassins in Matiwa. However, he believed that Madeline betrayed him. After he left active service with MI6, he is recruited by the CIA to find a kidnapped scientist named Valdo Obrushev, which leads to a showdown with a powerful adversary. That's how he went back to the international spy life. And that's basically the premise of this movie. I was really excited to see No Time to Die. I believe it was going to be released in November 2019, and then it got pushed back to February and April and November 2020. Now April and October 2021. So that's what I thought when the release dates got delayed. So I decided to watch this movie online. And what do I think of this movie? It was one of the best movies of 2021 I have ever seen. The acting from Daniel Craig, Rami Malek, Ana de Armas, Lea Seydoux, Jeffrey White, and Lashana Lynch are really great. The characters have a really good development. Nomi is an interesting new character for Bond's successor. The plot is very good and interesting. Savin is a really satisfying villain. The gun barrel sequence is great. The pacing is well done. The action sequences are really awesome. Even Billie Eilish's song of the same name is so beautiful to listen to. So you know what's unexpected? Bond gets infected by Savin that prevents him to escape from the island. While he is on his way to defeat Savin, he gets blown up by missiles while he is still at the island. His death was actually very sad and emotional. It was actually a strong send-off to the Daniel Craig 007 era. And sure, that movie was too long, but it's worth 2 hours and 43 minutes. Overall, No Time to Die is the best in the Daniel Craig 007 era, and I give this movie an A+ for fantastic. And I finished reviewing all the Daniel Craig 007 movies. So thank you for watching my review on No Time to Die. Let me know what you think of this movie in the comments below. I'll see you guys later.